I was born Marissa Lynn Cozine on November 17, 1994, in Barrington, Illinois. My family is made up of my mom, Susan, my dad, Mark, and my three younger siblings, Matthew, Nathan, and Gretchen. As an infant in Erickson's first stage of trust versus mistrust, I found that the world was a safe place due to my parents' safe and reliable care. Soon after this, as a toddler, in Erickson's second stage of autonomy versus shame and doubt, I began to assert my independence, choosing my own clothes, feeding myself, and choosing when to nap. Fortunately for my parents, sleep was very important to me, and I chose to take two naps a day when I was tired. This continued until the day my parents brought my brother Matthew home from the hospital. On that day, I decided that big girls didn't take naps, and I took on a very mothering role with my brother. I was also in Kohlberg's stage of pre-conventional morality, where my moral code was shaped by the standards set by adults and the consequences of breaking the rules. My parents couldn't say the word no around me if I was doing something wrong or dangerous, because I'd start sobbing immediately. Instead, my mom would just have to make a noise like, mm-mm, and I would stop what I was doing right away to avoid punishment. When it was time to sign me up for preschool, my parents picked a Montessori school not too far away. There I had the freedom to be independent and discover through working with materials rather than through direct instruction. I took full advantage of this opportunity to move around and do my own thing. My absolute favorite activity was to pound nails into a tree stump with my child-sized safety goggles and hammer. I also loved to paint and dress up to put on musical shows for my mom when I was at home. In your PJs, getting ready for school. Oh, darling, don't you ever go. Don't you ever go. In elementary school, I found that I loved to read, write, and do math. I was very good at these things, winning approval from my teachers and parents. This helped me through Erickson's fourth stage, industry versus inferiority. I became industrious, and I couldn't wait to go to school each morning. I also tried every athletic activity my parents offered to me. I liked to play soccer, t-ball, Girl Scouts, and dance. At this point in my life, I was very word smart and body smart. As Gardner describes, I was able to use my words very well, and I never had to study very hard because I could always remember the information and reading my teachers gave me. I also liked to do things by moving around. Throughout elementary school, middle, and high school, I attended local public schools. The public schools in my area had very good reputations. My parents specifically moved to my hometown of Mount Prospect, Illinois, to the school system. There wasn't much reason to send my siblings and me to a private school. My high school is very focused on using technology in the classroom. The year I graduated, my school was in the process of getting iPads to every student. Currently, almost every student has the use of an iPad in class for notes, textbooks, and apps for studying. This seems like a good idea in theory, but I know from talking to my younger brothers that most students just play games on them and get distracted during class. When I entered middle school, I was also entering Piaget's formal operational level. I could think in an abstract manner. I could also manipulate ideas in my head without any dependence on concrete manipulation. It was by this time that I was also in Kohlberg's stage of conventional morality. I did the right thing because I wanted to be seen as a good person, not just avoiding punishment. I wanted to be a good role model for my siblings and leave a good legacy with my teachers for my brother. I wanted the Cozine name to be associated with kindness, respect, and intelligence. At this point, I was more focused on Maslow's third stage in his hierarchy of needs. My biological and safety needs were met, so I felt the need to belong. I worked on my friendships and relationships to feel loved and like I belonged in my peer group. I spent nearly every day after school at my friends' houses. Even though I was focused on my social life, I still spent most of my time on schoolwork, even working on homework while at friends' houses. All
high school, it became clear that academics were going to be my first priority. At this point, I felt that intelligence was a part of my personal identity. I was going through Erikson's fifth stage of identity versus role confusion, and I did not really know who I was supposed to be. I had no idea what college I wanted to go to or what I would study, so I just tried to be the best at every subject. I took every AP class my counselor allowed me to take, and the rest had to be at least honors classes. The identity I created for myself was the girl who was overcommitted to everything and put her social life on. You better know, you better know. I just wanna know you. Student, I am much more in touch with my identity. I found a nice balance between studying and spending time with friends or in activities that I enjoy. As an auditory learner, classes that are lecture-based are not a problem for me. I'm currently in Erikson's sixth stage of intimacy versus isolation. Success in this stage can lead to comfortable relationships and a sense of commitment. After learning about developmental theories, typical and atypical development, and brain research, I will be sure to vary my lessons with the teacher to tailor to different students with different learning styles. Also, not every student will develop at the same rate that I did, and those that I know.